If you clicked on this video, congratulations, because you are starting on the first step to fixing these issues. And the issues that I'm talking about are anger and bitterness towards women. This is a really tough thing for men to admit to themselves when they're feeling these feelings. It's a tough thing. It's not even really acceptable in society to have these feelings in the first place. But at the end of the day, it's kind of understandable. And you're putting yourself out there, like you're asking girls out on dates, like, or you're trying to get a phone number. I mean, again and again, year after year, if you're experiencing nothing but rejection, people are being mean to you, your self-esteem can't take it anymore, and eventually you become angry and bitter. And the problem when you get in this area is because you're angry and bitter towards women, when you talk to them to try and attract them, your anger and bitterness comes out. And because of that, they react with anger and bitterness, and then you become more angry and bitter, and it's this vicious cycle that keeps going. So how do you fix this? Well, in this video, I'm going to be giving you two things. Number one, I'm going to be giving you mindset shifts, which are going to start you on the track to be able to start solving these issues. And then two, I'm going to give you practical tips to, once you start solving them, to keep going, and eventually you're going to have these feelings not bother you anymore. Now, you won't be able to completely get rid of them. In my life, like I used to hate women. I mean, I was super angry and bitter towards them. But I don't really have those feelings so much anymore, but they're there. It's kind of like depression where you have this monkey on your back. You know how to feed the monkey. You know how to ignore him. You know how to, you won't even notice the monkey's there for years, but sometimes he comes back. And so when that monkey does come back, do the things that I'm talking about in this video, and you'll be right back on track and be able to continue with your life and having fun and getting positive experiences from women, because ultimately that's how you're going to solve this issue. The first thing that I'm going to tell you in this video is that it's okay to have these feelings. This is not a popular opinion, like I said. It's okay to be angry and bitter towards women. Like I said, it's probably understandable given your circumstance or given what's happened to you in the past. So now that we find out it's okay, we can start solving them. And the truth is, you're not the only one. There's probably more people clicking on these videos. There's probably more people experiencing these. I know this because that was one thing that happened to me that got me on the track to start solving this problem. Man, I used to be so angry and bitter towards women because I was constantly rejected. I felt like a loser. And once I started realizing that I wasn't the only guy suffering from these things, and not only the only guy, but guys that were doing well with women, I found out were having some of these issues too, where they experienced anger and bitterness. They were like, they're mad that, you know, girls would do this, or that they felt rejection a lot of times, just the way I did too. I just thought, like, you know, in college, the guys in the frat house or whatever, they just didn't have these feelings, and I was just a loser. So once I realized that other people were experiencing this, I realized, okay, well, if other people are experiencing this, then I can solve it. I can fix it. If these guys have gotten past it and are able to succeed, I can get past this too. I started asking myself why. That's where you want to start with. Start with why. Why am I having these feelings? Why do I feel so angry and bitter? Okay, well, it's because she was mean to me, or she didn't like me. Well, was she because she didn't like you, or because she didn't come home with you? It's because she rejected me. Okay, well, once I started going down this path and asked, why did she reject you? Okay, why did that make you mad? Why did that make you mad? It got to the point where I realized it was just because the girls that I liked didn't like me back. The girls that I was attracted to, that I wanted to sleep with and date, they didn't want anything to do with me. There were girls that did, but I didn't like them. Once I had that realization, I started to ask myself, okay, well, what can I do to fix this? Well, the short answer to that question is get more attractive and make yourself into a guy that they want to sleep with. The problem is I didn't know how to do that. I thought I was actually a catch. It sounds crazy to say, but back when I was 19 and had like no game whatsoever and sucked with women completely and couldn't get laid to save my life, I thought I was a catch, and that's what pissed me off the most. I was smart, I was in physics, I was fit, I was playing sports, I thought I was charismatic and funny, I wasn't. You know, I thought I had all these great qualities to myself, but in reality I didn't. I wasn't really that successful, I didn't have a lot of cool friends, the friends that I did have were also angry and bitter like me, I wasn't really that charismatic, and on top of that, I was lost in life. I didn't really have a direction that I was going, and I wasn't driven and ambitious, and it didn't look like I was going to be able to accrue resources, and that's the kind of thing that women look for implicitly when, you know, you read evolutionary psychology. Once I realized this, that I was lacking, that I just wasn't attractive. It sounds like a really debilitating thing, but it finally made me free because I wasn't confused anymore. I realized the problem was me and I could fix this. That was the biggest difference, was that I could fix this problem. I could make myself attractive. I could make myself get those positive experiences with women. And once I start doing that, then I can start not being angry and bitter anymore and start loving them. So take a long look at yourself. Ask yourself this question: why would a woman date you? Why would a woman date you? Watch my channel, like, understand women a little bit better, the stuff that they're into, the stuff that they're attracted to. Do you fulfill those qualities? A lot of guys, I find, and I'm not saying everybody, some are dealt a really bad card, but some guys, their anger and bitterness for women is kind of unfounded, because they're the type of guy that will walk into a bar, they'll try and talk to the hottest girl there, she'll reject him, and then they'll just slump in the corner and be like, all women are bitches, all women suck, they just care about money. Don't be that guy. Okay, look at yourself in the mirror and give yourself a long, hard appraisal. Really be honest. See where you're lacking. And once you have that, you're going to realize, oh, I can improve this. I can get better at this. And the good thing about being a guy, dude, is that men get better with age. An 18-year-old guy and an 18-year-old girl do not have the same mate value. Who do you think has more of a high mate value? The 18-year-old girl. Way more. Way more. Why? Because older women, women in their 20s, they're not trying to fuck 18-year-old guys. Guys in their 20s, they're still trying to fuck that 18-year-old girl. They still find her attractive because she's at peak fertility. All men are competing for these women. So during college and after college, I thought that, you know, a woman around my age was like, we'd have the same mate. We don't. We don't. And the good news is that you're getting smarter with age, you're getting more charismatic, your game is improving, you're getting more resources, your career's getting better, you're building up your social circle. So if you're a young guy, be patient, dude. Work on yourself, be better. This all comes down to understanding. So when you understand yourself more, when you understand women more, a lot of this confusion is gonna go away. Once the confusion goes away, you're gonna be a lot less angry. It's tough to hate things that you understand. The other thing that helped me too was a little bit of perspective. You know, everyone's dealing with shit in life. They all deal with rejection, except women deal with it a little bit different. So they like to be, women usually compete for commitment and men compete for sex. And men get rejected sexually way more than women do. It's not even close. So women are very choosy about that. But when it comes to commitment, usually they have trouble getting a guy to stick around, or they usually having to get a guy to commit fully or to want to marry them or to actually like spend time and want to like, you know, raise a child with them. That's the rejection that they experience. It's not the same, but it still happens. All right. So now that we've talked a lot about the mindset shifts, let's talk a little bit about the practical tips. So now we're starting to be able to go out and have good experiences. Okay. We're starting on that path. We're not quite there yet, but we're starting on that path. Don't do what I said before, which is like, you know, walk up, try and talk to the hottest girl in the bar, and then she rejects you and then slump in a corner and get pissed off. I would start talking with people that you know you're going to get a good reaction from. They might not always be the girls that you're attracted to, but start with them, get some positive reference points. That way you're in a good frame of mind, so when that girl that you do like comes over, you're ready for it. Stop focusing on the end result too. What I found that what made me the most angry when I was going out was when I was so, like, I have to get laid tonight or something, or I have to find a girl. Once you start getting that, you're gonna get really angry and disappointed when it doesn't happen. Instead, focus on something easier, like try and have fun, try and have good interactions and meet cool people, and then you practice taking it in direction where you want it to. If you wanna sleep with a girl that night, or maybe you wanna get a girl out on a date, whatever you wanna do, start with having good interactions with people, having fun. Once you start with that mentality, it's gonna take a little bit of pressure off yourself and you're not gonna get as emotional. And then on top of that, focus on small wins. Sometimes you go out and like 20 girls don't want to talk to you. It sucks. It might suck, but you might get that one girl that laughed at your joke, or you might get that one girl that smiled at you. Anything that you can have to focus on that's positive, take that away. Because if you focus on only the negative, you focus on only the negative stuff that happens to you, you're going to become a bitter and negative person yourself. And the last thing that I'm going to say in this video is don't give up. Dealing with these issues is, as a straight guy or a guy who's, you know, dealing with women, you're gonna have to deal with women in your life. And if you have a negative mindset towards them, your life is gonna be shit. It's not gonna be fun. As a man, we're here to survive and we're here to replicate. That's what every living thing is. Once you have your survival down, the replication part obviously becomes a big side of our ego. the mates that we can attract, the offspring that we can have, is going to be something that's pretty important to us. And if we don't figure out how to handle our feelings surrounding this, it's going to be very difficult for us to be satisfied with ourselves. So please keep at it. You will get positive experiences if you start the process that I said, but don't give up. Don't just sit on your couch and watch, videos online that are going to make you more angry towards women. Start focusing on the positive stuff, and it will happen. I guarantee it. So thanks a lot, you guys. If you made it to the end, consider subscribing. In the comments below, if you want to put some experiences that you had or some feelings that you have that you want to get out, I read all the comments, dude. And the ones that have questions, the ones that I think that are good, I will respond to them, especially on this video. This is a very, this is an important subject. So if you want to do that, or you can email me at thesingleguy2017@gmail.com. If you're interested in my mentorship one-on-one coaching program, shoot me an email there as well. Thanks a lot, you guys. Good luck out there.